for 10 or 15 minutes after the goal when the crowd was still going mad. To be honest, I think that feeling was just, yeah, it was unbelievable.
It's Shearer, he scored on his debut!
It's Shearer for Newcastle!
Shearer, oh, sensational!
Drops for Shearer, oh! Trust Alan Shearer to provide it!
Alan Shearer, the Premier League's all-time top goal scorer.
Never get tired of people saying that, so thank you.
Now, there might be a few younger Premier League fans who didn't have the pleasure of watching you live.
Are you trying to tell me I'm getting on a little bit?
That is not, that's in the script, that wasn't from me. But they didn't get to see you live, I luckily did. But if you could maybe describe and explain, like, what made you such a special striker and why did you score that many goals?
Well, I wasn't, when I went down to Southampton as a 15-year-old boy, leaving Newcastle, going down there, I wasn't one of the best. In fact, I was probably near the bottom when everyone came together. But what I was better than anyone else at was working hard. Just the hours on the training ground, I think. I worked so hard and I was determined, and because that's all I knew. Football was all I knew when I left home. So I wouldn't have had a clue what I would have done if it wasn't for football. So without doubt, it was hard work.
We'll get into it. So we've somehow whittled your 260 goals down to your 8 best and most memorable Premier League goals, as voted for by Premier League fans. Mm-hmm. And it's your role to choose your one ultimate. You ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay. Yeah, be little tough. Walk down memory lane. Okay, so to kick us off, we've got some firsts. We're going to start with your first ever Premier League goal for Blackburn against Crystal Palace back in 1992. What are your memories of that first ever Premier League goal?
Just sheer relief, because I remember being Britain's most expensive player and the heat and the pressure being on me.
It's Shearer, he scored on his debut! Alan Shearer, Britain's most expensive footballer, starts to repay the fee with that cracking volley.
I think for any centre-forward, to score in your first game is really important, because it takes the heat off you, it takes the pressure off you, builds your confidence up. I remember that day really well.
Of course, you won the title during your time at Blackburn as well. How special a moment was that in your career, and where would you like rank that achievement, because you have so many milestones and achievements?
Well, for little old Blackburn to come into the Premier League from the first division as it was then, coming up in the playoffs and then coming on and taking the might of Manchester United and Liverpool and Arsenal and all these teams. So to win the title was just an amazing feeling.
Another first was the first time you scored for your hometown club, Newcastle, this time against Wimbledon. What do you remember about that goal?
I remember everything. I remember looking at the goalkeeper in the middle of the goal and thinking, if I get enough pace and bend on the ball here, then I've got half a chance, because I was always confident of doing that. It was my dream to score at St James's Park. I'd been there as a kid, I'd watched my hero, Kevin Keegan, and all the Newcastle players score goals. But for me to get my first goal at St James's Park, with being the world's most expensive player there, again, it was just, I mean, it was sheer joy, relief in front of all my family, so it was an amazing feeling.
To have that world record transfer fee at your hometown club, does that add a lot of pressure as well? You talk about that relief when you finally score, but does that add on top of it?
It never weighed me down. I thought if people were crazy enough to pay that fee, I mean, £15 million now doesn't seem like a lot of money, but £15 million back in 1996 was like bizarre. It was a crazy amount of money. So, but I enjoyed it. I thought if someone was prepared to have that much faith in me and that belief in me, then I had to repay them, and thankfully I did.
Okay, so what goal are we going to choose? We got two firsts.
God, this is really tough.
What means more to you?
I'm going to have to say the Newcastle one, because it was the club I supported. It was at St James's Park. I'd been there so many times as a fan. So I'm going to have to say the Newcastle v Wimbledon one.
Okay. I don't think any fans would blame you for
choosing
that.
I'll put the W in there, shall I? Wimbledon. There you go.
Wimbledon. We're going to move on to two of your most stunning goals. The first is a brilliant piece of individual skill against Norwich with a beautiful chip. Do you remember this?
I remember it very well, yeah. I think I played a bit of a 1-2 just inside in my own half and then got the ball back. And then running and thinking, no one's actually closing me down here. And then I thought, OK, that's inviting. And then I seen Brian Gunn off his line just ahead of the 6-yard box. And it was such a great game. We were leading anyway, so I just thought, why not try it? It was one of those where I caught it really sweet. I couldn't have caught it any better. It was it was the perfect lob, I think. And he didn't even move the goalkeeper, so it worked perfectly.
Did Brian have a word with you after that game?
He still does to this day whenever I see him, yeah. I never fail to mention it in front of him.
That goal goes up against one of your finest strikes where you managed to hit, an absolute corker. And turning one of the best defenders in the Premier League as well, Marcel Desailly. What do you remember about that?
Yeah, I remember using my body a lot and backing into Marcel when the ball was coming into me. And I'd played against him before, so I knew how great he was, and everyone knew the great Marcel Desailly. But I was really amazed that he let me control him in that situation. And then, of course, he let me come inside onto my right foot, which I didn't need a second invitation to have a pop.
Shearer, just look how well he held off Desailly. Oh, save! Sensational from Alan Shearer!
When these things come off, it's like, oh, my God, it looks so great. But you try them so many times in training and they very rarely come off. So when they're doing a match, I mean, the feeling's just insane. So when I saw it hit the back of the net, it was like, wow, it's come off. And I was real happy.
Yeah, I mean, it's not the first time you scored a goal like that as well. Like, you must, when you hit these sort of shots, like, you've had so many where you just hit it so well. Mm. Do you just know as soon as you've hit it, it's like, that's it?
Yeah, because you just see the flight of the ball straight away. Yeah. And I sort of knew that when I hit it, because I hit it on the top of the ball, so I knew straight away. I knew I'd caught it well. I knew it had a chance of going in. So, thankfully, it did.
Beautiful. So, two goals, two different eras, two different Alan Shearers, you could say.
Yeah, it was absolutely. Yeah.
What one are you choosing to go through?
I think because of who it was against, and I'm not being disrespectful to Norwich, but because it was against Chelsea and the great Marcel Desailly, I'm going to have to say the Newcastle v Chelsea one.
Okay,
so
beautiful.
The Chelsea one.
As an Arsenal fan, I like that. We've got two big career milestone goals. Mm. So, firstly, a momentous goal against Portsmouth in February 2006.
It's Shearer for Newcastle!
Surpassing Jackie Milburn to become Newcastle's all-time leading goal scorer. How much did that mean to you, that moment?
Yeah, I mean, it wasn't so much a great goal, it was just the occasion and what it meant. And I knew that I was retiring in the May.
Yeah.
So the sooner I got that goal, the better. And never did I ever think that going back to Newcastle in 96, some 10 years later, I would have the Newcastle record.
Crucially though, the one goal advantage is still in the Newcastle column. Here comes Alan Shearer. It's Shearer for Newcastle! Alan Shearer in front of the Gallagates, 201 goals for Newcastle United.
The feeling after that goal, I mean, for 10 or 15 minutes after the goal, when the crowd was still going mad, I mean, it still brings a sort of a shiver to me now. The excitement and the feeling that goal brought for me as a local lad that's from Newcastle.
Dream
I'm not
come
sure
true,
it
right?
gets any better than that. To be honest, I think that feeling was just. Yeah, it was unbelievable, yeah.
Amazing. Well, I mean, that might be an early favourite there for the ultimate Premier League goal, but we have another special goal against Sunderland in April 2006. This one's your final ever Premier League goal. Maybe a bittersweet moment for you as well.
Well, actually, that goal against Sunderland in April 2006 was my last ever touch of a football
and
in
it was a
professional game.
Alan Shearer says as he gets older, the feeling of scoring gets sweeter and sweeter, and that will taste very nice indeed. In his last Weir Tyne derby, Alan Shearer has put Newcastle United in front.
There was huge pressure on me. We were being beaten 1-0 at half-time in the game, I remember. The relief was huge from a personal point of view and of course, for the team. So. yeah, that was an unbelievable feeling. But at the time, I didn't know it was going to be the last ever touch of a football.
Yeah. So, I mean, looking back now, we've got two very, very special goals. You've got the record breaker.
This is such a difficult choice
because of the... it's tough.
They're both hugely important goals in my career.
Unfortunately, you have to choose.
Okay, I'm going to choose the Portsmouth one then.
Okay.
As soon as you said goosebumps,
I knew it was going to be that.
It was such a difficult choice, though, because they both meant so much to me.
Moving on, the final grouping, we have two classic volleys. I think everyone will have seen these goals. We're going to start with a goal that many people still think is a cross. And maybe you can help us resolve this, but it's your volley against Aston Villa in November 2001.
Well, my answer to that would be, if you look actually in the box, there's no one there.
Okay.
So it's never, ever going to be a cross.
Rob Lee. Shearer. Oh, he's found his touch again. There's nothing worse for a defence than Alan Shearer with a point to prove.
It meant a lot because it was the great Peter Schmeichel in goal and his response. I mean, we've had some unbelievable battles over the years.
We've got
much respect for Peter because of what he's achieved in his great career. So to see him sort of motionless and just stood there was pretty good. But I think the Everton goal, and I know people have their own opinions, but I think the Everton goal for me maybe have been my best goal.
Up towards Aniobi, drops for Shearer. Oh! They were in need of something special. Trust Alan Shearer to provide it.
Again, just caught it so sweet. And I knew that with the dip on it, that as soon as I hit the connection with it, then it was going in the back of the net. So, and I've said it before, but I think that Everton goal was probably, my technique-wise, my best goal. I'm going to say the Everton one, yeah.
Beautiful. A perfect hit in the Premier League.
Yeah, nice one.
On to the semi-finals. Now you have to put these goals against each other. So we've got your first goal for Newcastle against Wimbledon, going up against that goal for Portsmouth, the record breaker.
Yeah, I mean, I've described that feeling of breaking Jackie Milburn's record and the Newcastle record at the Gallagher end. And for a local boy who was brought up in Newcastle, then I'm going to have to say that that goal against Portsmouth.
Amazing. OK, so the Portsmouth goal was through onto the other side. Mm. So we've got your stunner against Chelsea and then the legendary volley against Everton. This is very difficult, but I don't know.
It is. I mean, again, they're very different. I do think that Everton won for technique-wise, because I think volleying, particularly from a distance out and getting the accuracy and the power, I think that's probably the most difficult skill.
Yeah. From an angle as well.
From a bit of an angle. So I'm going to have to say the Everton won technique-wise. I think that probably just beats that goal against Chelsea and Marcel, so Everton.
Okay, we're on to the final. So, Alan Shearer, an absolute legend of the Premier League. What are you choosing for your ultimate Premier League goal?
My ultimate Premier League goal, the goal against Portsmouth at the Gallagher end to break a legend's record, my dad's hero, that feeling. I mean, to score a goal is an amazing feeling, but for me that day, as a local boy in front of all my family and friends, I'm going to have to say the goal against Portsmouth.
Amazing. That is beautiful. I've got a teary-eyed at that, you know, beautiful moment.
So, yeah.
Amazing. Well, Alan, that is your ultimate Premier League goal. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks very much. Thank you.